I joined Asian Paints as what you call as a lateral manager. That is not directly from our campus, but I had held down a few jobs already.
Hi, I'm Keithi, Senior Manager HR. I've been now with the company for 7.5 years almost.
Hi, I'm Harsh Kinkre. I'm a Senior Manager Purchase at Asian Paints. I joined Asian Paints in 2013, straight after I did my MBA from IIM Kozhikode. So I've been with the organization for around 5.5 years now. My journey at APL started when I interned here in 2012. It was a challenging project, but I got great support from my mentors and whoever I interacted with along the way.
I still remember the first day of my job. In the induction, I was told that I'll be posted in Rohtak plant. I literally had to Google where this place was. So with a lot of anxiety and some bit of excitement as well, I landed there. And I remember very distinctly my first impression of the plant. It was beautiful. It was green. It was clean. It was a smart plant. It was almost like it was out of a mega factories episode.
When I joined as a management trainee, I started off as a production manager at the Kasna plant in Greater Noida.
Since it was a new plant, I got to work on setting up, thinking about experimenting in many cases, about things which would help set up people practices and processes which would really complement the world-class factory that we had set up there.
This is a competitive place, but it's not political. This is an organized place, but it's not hierarchical. Some days are good, some days are not so good. But even on the worst of days, you will be happy to know that you're part of something that's really larger than yourself. You're part of big projects, and at a very young age, you get that opportunity to do something that not a lot of your friends outside of the company are doing. That really helps keep you motivated for a long time.
In my 5.5 years, I've been fortunate to experience a wide variety of roles at Asian Paints. I've handled the production block, also the procurement of commodity chemicals as well as specialty chemicals. I've also had the chance to work on some really challenging and exciting big ticket projects which have taught me a lot.
One of my most cherished memories, if I were to say, from my stint there, was this program that we designed for the blue-collar workforce to move into white-collar roles, right? So it was a very challenging assignment. It's not very common in the industry to do this. But you know, even now when I meet these people and I've seen them take on higher responsibilities, it just fills me with so much pride, you know, because we've really been able to uplift their career story here. So it's one of my fondest memories from my stint there.
Probably what's really super here is how there's very little power distance between the leaders and the trainee who joined yesterday. So our hierarchy and our super managers are happy to show you the ropes and teach you a thing or two. But at the same time, they're even happier to learn from the youngest member in the team. And that actually makes it more fun to work with.
My tenure in production taught me a lot about machines, something which I always considered myself to be weak at and would run away from. Taught me a lot about unit operations and processes, but most importantly, it taught me how to manage people. Interactions ranged the entire spectrum, right from workmen on the shop floor to a plant head, to technical experts, to supply chain people. All of these interactions were really enriching in their own way.
If you think that something needs to be done as part of your role, you have the autonomy to take it up. What you do need is, of course, the conviction, and you know, need to be able to convince others. But then the world is your oyster, really. So that's one thing I really cherish here. The other thing which is very, very close to my heart is the peer group that I've found right from my plant stint up till now. Of course, you know, the seniors are mentors, they are friends. But what I really like is that they are bright minds, you know, and that helps me become better. So that's been my consistent experience across roles.
Before I joined here, a lot of people said, at Asian Paints, you make friends for life. I mean, that sounds cheesy, right? I wasn't sure that's how it was going to be for me, but I'm happy to have been proven wrong. So today, say, plays at the Prithvi Theatre, or game nights, or card games, or, you know, sometimes I've even had holidays. Colleagues do that together, and I must confess, some of my closest, dearest friends are from work.
The other thing that I love about this company is that I've always found the freedom to express my views, whether it's in front of my boss or, in fact, on many occasions in front of the CEO himself. Right? Point of views are taken on their merit, not really from who they are coming from, you know. So I think that's what helps people here become the best versions of themselves, rather than getting typecast into professionals in this corporate world.
So a lot of times when you don't know what really makes a place tick, I think we sort of boil it all down to it's the culture, it's the DNA of the place, etc. But I think for me, what makes Asian Paints tick is what this company truly values, how it really values its people, honesty, integrity, and day after day, how all of us put in only our best. And you know the unwritten codes and rules that your teammates follow when it comes to work, when it comes to respect? I think all of that makes the culture, and that's what makes Asian Paints stick.
And people are always there to sort of hear you out, you know, in during tough times. So when I look back, whenever I've been stuck professionally, there's always been someone who I can talk to. There's always been someone who has boosted my confidence and pointed me in the right direction. And I feel like that's extremely important for any professional to have.
I'm looking forward to many more exciting experiences here.